So a lot of you have asked me a lot of questions about the mountaineering courses that happens in India. Questions like how does one apply for the course, or which is the best institute, what is the fee structure like, or how does one train for the course, and what is the course structure like, what does one learn in these courses. I thought there are too many questions, and let's just put all of them in one single video. And in this one video, I will answer every possible question that you might have about the mountaineering courses in India. So here it is. So just to give you a little background about myself, I have done my basic mountaineering course from Nehru Institute of Mountaineering in Uttarkashi, and I have done my advanced mountaineering course in the Himalayan Mountaineering Institute in Darjeeling. So now let's take a look at which are the institutes in India that offers mountaineering courses. The first one is obviously the most famous one, Nehru Institute of Mountaineering. It's in Uttarkashi. The second one is Himalayan Mountaineering Institute. It's in Darjeeling in West Bengal. The third one is Atal Bihari Vajpayee Institute of Mountaineering and Allied Sports, ABWIMAS. It's in Manali in Himachal Pradesh. The fourth one is JIM, JIM, Jawahar Institute of Mountaineering. It's in Pahalgam in Kashmir. And the fifth one is NIMAS, National Institute of Mountaineering and Allied Sports. This institute is in Dirang in Arunachal Pradesh. So now let's take a look at some of the courses offered by these institutes which are related to mountaineering. The first one is the adventure course. It's a very very basic beginner level course. The second one is the basic mountaineering course. The third one is the advanced mountaineering course. The fourth one is the search and rescue course, and the fifth one is method of instruction course. So now let's speak about each of these courses individually. I'll give you guys a little brief about what these courses are all about. The adventure course is a 14-day long course specifically designed to introduce people to the world of outdoors and adventure by teaching them some very simple techniques like rappelling, rock climbing, jumaring, Burma bridge crossing, and other such fun techniques. This course is conducted in and around the institute area, and the course does not go into the high altitudes for glacier and snow training. The second one is the basic mountaineering course. Now, for everyone who is serious about mountaineering and they want to take their first step into the world of mountaineering, basic mountaineering course is the best first step. In these 28 days, the focus is mainly on three aspects of mountaineering: rock craft, ice craft, and snow craft. So the first 9 days are spent on the rock craft training. The rock craft training happens in and around the institute on the rock climbing areas which are near the campus and inside the campus where they have the artificial rock climbing wall. The rock craft training focuses mainly on teaching some of the techniques that are required while you are rock climbing, while you are on the rock, like how to handle the rope, how to handle the equipment, some of the basic knots, and some rock climbing techniques like rock climbing and rappelling and jumaring. Some of these techniques are taught in the rock craft training. The rock craft training mainly happens from morning to evening types, and in the evening after we are back in the institute, they conduct lectures in their classrooms, and these were the most interesting lectures that I have ever sat in. The lectures are conducted on topics like weather reading, map reading, and they speak about the history of mountaineering and the you know like the first ascent of Everest and so much more. And also in these lectures they are preparing us for the next 28 days that we are going to spend in the mountains for our glacial training. So yes, after the rock craft training is done, now it's time for the course to move to the mountains for the ice craft and the snow craft training. So the next 21 days are spent in the mountains learning various aspects of ice craft, snow craft, glacier walking, how to conduct rescues, various things about high altitude, and obviously you learn many many skills in the course, and but the one main thing that I really liked, what I learned personally, that you spend the whole 28 days with complete strangers, and trust me, at that altitude it is not easy to tolerate complete strangers with various habits and various personalities. So it literally pushes you out of the comfort zone. It completely breaks you, and they rebuild you in a very very beautiful and a very dynamic way. So I think this is the best part about doing the mountaineering course, that it just gets you out of your comfort zone. Those 28 days you learn so many little aspects about mountaineering, about how to survive in the mountains, how to exist in the mountains with complete strangers, and often these little things are something that makes a huge huge difference in the mountains. After you come back to the institute, you have a little examination kind of a thing. It's extremely simple, trust me. If you have basic sense and if you have paid a little attention in the course, you will be able to clear it. And after the examination, you have the graduation ceremony, which was probably a very very beautiful memory of my life, where I earned my mountaineering degree, and this is the only degree that I am really really proud of. After the basic mountaineering course, if you score an A grade, you can go for the advanced mountaineering course. In the advanced course, we are taught the same three main pillars, which is the rock, ice and snow craft. Just you learn a little more of the advanced techniques in the advanced course. And the one new thing you learn in the advanced mountaineering course is the expedition planning. So towards the end of the course, the instructors will give you one peak. You have to plan a complete expedition, from itinerary to the ration, to transport, to permits, to the costing, to sponsorship, everything. So it's a very 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 important learning experience, the expedition planning. If you complete the advanced mountaineering course with an A grade, you are eligible for the next two courses, which is the search and rescue course and the method of instruction course. Now the search and rescue course, naam se hi pata lag jayega aapko kya hai wo. In the mountains, things don't always go according to as we have planned or how we want it. So in these unfortunate circumstances, some really important skills like searching, rescue and recovery, these are some of the very very important techniques that every mountaineer needs to know, needs to have an experience on. And these techniques are taught in the search and rescue course. It's a 21 day long course. And the MOI, the method of instruction course, is for the people who are aspiring to be instructors in these institutes. So this course is basically designed to teach you how to teach. So what is the course ka fees? How much does this course cost? Well, the fees keeps on changing time to time. And if I give you a number right now, this video might not be relevant in the next 5 years. So I'm not gonna give you the numbers right now, but all I would like to inform you guys that this course is conducted by the government of India, and it's a heavily subsidized course, and it is very very cheap for Indians. You can go on their websites and check the fees out. Itni mehnat kar sakte ho aap log. So what is the criteria to be selected for the course? If you speak about the age criteria, between the age of 16 and the age of 42 is what is officially allowed. But I don't know, mujhe ye baatein kehni chahiye ki nahi, but unofficially, if you show that you are capable physically, mentally, for the course, then I have seen people above the age of 42 also enrolling for the course. The second criteria is that you have to be physically and mentally very 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 fit, because it's a 28 day long rigorous course, and it will push you to your limits physically and also mentally. So you need to train well before the course. Apart from being physically and mentally fit, you also need to be medically fit. So there is a medical form that you need to get filled by a physician, and if everything is okay in that form, in those tests, only then you are eligible for the course. And the one question that people ask me, are glasses okay? Yes, it is absolutely okay. I also wear glasses. Now let's speak about how to apply for these courses. Well, har course ka alag tarika hai apply karne ka. For some you can apply online, for some you have to send a physical courier. So itni mehnat ek aap karo, agar aapko apply karna hai to in courses ki website pe jao, pura step by step details diya hua hai, okay? So itni mehnat aap log kijiye. Now this is the most frequently asked question, which is the best institute to do the courses. There is no good or bad institute, I am telling you. Now har institute mein kuch points bahut acche hai, kuch points bahut acche nahi hai. So you cannot compare the institutes, at least I am not able to compare the institutes, but ek reputation ban gayi hai bahar ki NIM, Nehru Institute of Mountaineering, is regarded as the best institute, and maine mera basic course wahan se kiya hai, and I know the reason for that. NIM is regarded as the best institute because of the disciplined way in which the course is being conducted, okay? But apart from discipline, we are going there to learn mountaineering skills, and as far as I am concerned, the mountaineering skills that are taught in all these institutes are practically of the same standard. Personally, it completely depends on how attentive you are throughout the course, how thirsty for knowledge you are, because all these instructors are extremely experienced people, okay? And it completely depends on you, that how much you are able to extract out of them. So if you are a good student, then any institute is the best institute. And other very important point that personally I would like to add, NIM, HMI, these are the two institutes where the waiting period for the basic mountaineering course is practically around 2 years as of 2020. And if you ask me, it is not worth the wait. For the basic mountaineering course, I would suggest that wherever you are getting the earliest seat, that's where you should go. Because aap ABCD kaun se school se seekhe ho, wo matter nahi karta hai, theek hai? So just get done with the course. And as far as advanced course is concerned, personally I would recommend NIM. So moving on, another very frequently asked question is, how fit do you need to be for the mountaineering courses, and what do you need to prepare before going to the course? As far as knowledge is concerned, I would say if you are a complete blank slate, agar kuch bhi nahi pata hai mountaineering ke bare mein, to wo best hai, because jisko thoda thoda pata hota hai na, usko adhuri adhuri jankari bahut khatarnak hoti hai. So you'll have to unlearn that first, and then you can learn something new. But if you know nothing at all, then it is the best state to be in. Now let's talk about what are the physical requirements and what to expect on the course physically, and how does one train for it. Fitness wise, it is extremely important to be fit, and you need to prepare well, because the training days are long, the treks are long. Basically, you need to be used to walking for long hours. And to prepare for the course, I would suggest you start your training schedule 6 months prior to the course. So for your training, you need to focus on mainly two areas. The first one is the cardiovascular strength, which is the stamina aspect. And the second one is the muscular endurance, the muscle strength. To increase your stamina, to work on your stamina, you can do running, jogging, cycling, swimming, or if you go to the gym, the elliptical, or the gym cycling, or walking on the treadmill. There are many, many options out there, and you must do these cardiovascular exercises for 3 times in a week. And now along with that, for your muscle strength, for your muscular endurance part, you can either go to the gym for your weight training. You can target each individual muscles, or you can do the CrossFit sessions, or you can do the functional training. or you can do calisthenics, which is the body weight training. So options are endless. Just figure out what works for you and what is giving you the result. And obviously, along with the training, if the nutrition is not right, then the training is of no use at all. So you need to figure out what food works for you and what training works for you. So this is one question a lot of people ask me, that what are the kind of workouts that are conducted in the course. Well, obviously you have to wake up very early in the morning, and these workouts are conducted only in the initial 9 days of the course. You have to gather in the morning, in the cold morning, and they start off with a very simple warm-up routine, and then on most days you go out for a run around the institute on the roads, and on some days they conduct some body weight exercises like push-ups and squats and lunges and crunches, and on some days there are nice long yoga sessions. And these routines are usually concluded by a nice cool down and a stretching session. So yes, what's next after you do these course? What are the kind of possibilities that open up? Well, of course, if you have completed the basic mountaineering course, the advanced course is the next option for you, if you have gotten an A grade, obviously. Apart from that, if you have done the BMC, you can think about attempting a few of the easier 5000 and 6000 meter peaks. For example, Stoke Kangri ho gaya, Kangyat Se 2 ho gaya, Friendship Peak, Kanamo. These are some of the easier peaks that you can think about attempting. And for those who have completed the advanced mountaineering course, you can take your mountaineering game to the next level. And there is no limit at all to now what you can do. Step by step, gradually aage leke jana hai. So yes, I think I have covered almost everything that you can possibly want to know before going for the courses. And just one thing I would like to share with you guys before I end this video. Just go and have bloody fun. Just have a blast in the mountains. Just have fun, because it's so beautiful out there, and it's such a privilege to be in the mountains amongst the best of the instructors, best people of your field, and amongst the future mountaineers of our generation. And there's just so much to learn, and you'll make memories for a lifetime in those 28 days, and life won't ever be the same again. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this was helpful, because you know, a lot of hard work goes into making such videos, and the whole intention is just to give you the right kind of information, the right kind of guidance, which I hope that I had when I started off. So yeah, thank you so much for watching the video. Thank you so much, guys.